It can be overwhelming going from nothing to a well-produced, published podcast with many steps you could potentially fall down on. Here's our step-by-step guide on how to record, edit, and publish a podcast. When I first started podcasting, I wasn't too sure where to start. When I was looking around, there were a bunch of ultimate podcast guides that go into detail I just wasn't prepared for. I just wanted to know how I got from my episode idea to a published show in my subscribers' feed. Let's break down how you do it in under 10 minutes. Recording remote podcasts is a challenge in itself. We've just published another full video on how to record a remote podcast you can watch here. But here's a rundown of how. Preparation really is the difference between a good and a bad show. Create detailed show notes, schedule and automate as much as you can. Create documents and processes that make it very clear how you run your podcasts. Once you've done all of your preparation, it's time to get recording. Create your show in riverside.fm and invite your guests. I'm going to invite our head of marketing, Abel, to show you how to record the show on Riverside. Once he's in, check the levels, make sure he's wearing headphones, press record and wait 5 seconds before it starts recording. If you want to see an in-depth tour of the Riverside platform, you can watch the video in the card in the top right-hand corner of the screen. Being a good host is an art in itself. There are different interview techniques you can use to craft the conversation to ensure it's an engage and listen for your audience. Focus on keeping the energy high and the conversation flowing. Remember that podcasting is also an entertainment medium, so try and combine value and entertainment. Once you've completed your preparation and recording, it's time to get into the editing. There is so much detail we can go into regarding editing, so we'll be recording some more in-depth tutorials on this channel. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on these. Head to your riverside.fm dashboard and get your recording. For the sake of this example, I'll use an audio version of the Indie Bites podcast that I produce. So all I need is a separate audio files for myself and Dan from this recording session. Editing can get quite complex, so make sure you organise everything so it's easy to find at a later date. Here's how I manage my folder structure. I have podcast, episode title, asset type, and then the file. Once you've got all your files organised, you can pull it into your editing software. I'll use GarageBand, for example, because it's the free audio editing software on a Mac. So if you've got a Mac, you'll be able to edit using this. Import your files onto the separate tracks, and then you're ready to edit. The first thing I do is adjust the levels throughout to make sure it's loud enough so people can hear it with headphones. Generally, peak levels of -1 should be good for you. You don't want it to be clipping and too loud so it gets extorted like this. Then I'll clip out the start and the end of the recording when we're doing our pre-chat and my I'll stop recording now, don't close your tab at the end. From this point, I get deep into the edit. I'll close all my other windows and I'll get editing. While I go, I'll get together some other assets such as music and stings, if your podcast uses stings. I get all my audio for Epidemic Sound, which I'd recommend. Cut out any errors throughout. Dogs barking, poor answers and stutters are all candidates for being cut. I also like removing all the ums and ahs in my podcast, so we'll take as many as sounds natural. The final part of the edit is adding the intros and the outros and doing one final full listen of the podcast to make sure I haven't noticed any errors. Then it's time to export. You can export a high-quality lossless WAV format that most podcast hosts accept, although the file size can be quite large. Or you can export a lossy MP3 or AAC file, which will be slightly slower quality, but the file size will be smaller, so it might be a bit easier for you to upload. With your exported file, it's now time to upload to your host. I use transistor.fm to host Indie Bites, so here's a walkthrough of how I use Transistor to publish. I write the episode summary and the show notes separately, usually while I'm editing or shortly after listening back to the episode. The episode summary is a short paragraph explaining the premise of that particular episode and what is covered. Make this as enticing as possible so people want to listen. Show notes are more in depth, and here you can include links. Include links from references discussed in the episode, add bios of your guests, and a more detailed rundown of the talking points covered throughout the episode. Spend some time crafting engaging podcast notes so people can find out more about you and the show and the guest once they've listened to an episode. Make custom podcast art if you can. If you have a template you can use to make the podcast art different for every episode, this will make the experience better for the listener. don't worry about this too much, but if you're looking for those marginal gains to make yourself stand out, this is a way to do it. Everything's now done. It's time to schedule your episode to go live. Do one last check of all the info you put into the podcast host, select a time and date to release your episode and press publish. Note that some podcast directories take a little while to propagate, so it may show up in Apple Podcasts a few hours later than you publish. So that's something to bear in mind. So there you have it, a podcast from idea to published. Hopefully the steps are easy enough to follow and now you're prepared to go out and get your podcast started. Here's a quick recap. Preparation is key. Make smart documents with useful processes to ensure things don't go wrong. Get some nice gear to have a good sounding podcast and create your show in Riverside.fm. Once you've recorded, you can get into the editing. You can use a free software like GarageBand to do this. Top and tail, edit out any mistakes and add in some additional assets for good production value. Once you've finished your edit, export in a high quality WAV format. The hard work is now done. Time to get your episode published. Upload your audio file to your podcast host, then create an engaging episode summary and detailed show notes. Make some custom art if you feel like it. Press publish and your podcast is out into the world. We want to hear from you. Leave a comment with the best thing you've done to improve your podcast, whether that's buying a new mic or switching to Riverside.fm. We're going to be producing a bunch more videos on this YouTube channel about podcasting, video interviews, and more. So if you want to learn more about starting and growing a podcast, make sure you subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss an episode. Thanks for watching.